Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about preservation by sugar, so which includes a set of products like your jam, jellies and marmalades. And this class we will discuss about another set of products, so which include your preserves, candies, crystallized and glazed fruits, so which are again preserved by high concentration of sugar. So let's discuss about these products, how they are being prepared, and while preparing, what are the challenges we encounter in their preparation and production. Let's see what all the various products that can be preserved by using sugar. So in this particular lecture, so which involves a preserve, a candy, a glazed fruit, crystallized fruit, and how they differ from each other. So preserve is basically a fruit which is cooked in sugar syrup, and slowly its concentration is increased so that the sugar concentration in the fruit is increased. So here in this preserve, you are not going to make it into a fine pulp, or you are not going to make it into a paste or something. The fruit or the fruit pieces are allowed to cook till they are become tender and become transparent. So till it is become transparent, you cook them, and then simultaneously the sugar from the cooking medium gets into the fruit, gets entry into the fruit, making it as a preserve. So that means it is a fruit or a vegetable which is impregnated with heavy sugar syrup, so till it becomes a tender and transparent one. So like you have different preserves from amla or your karanda, pineapple, papaya. So these are all popular preserves that are available, so which is mostly called as murabbas in the colloquial language. Before going into the details of production of preserve, let's see briefly about various other products so that are prepared from the preserve, like candy, glazed fruit, crystallized, and these are the three different types of products that can be prepared from the preserve. So basically these three are produced from preserve. So once you prepare a preserve, so by impregnating, the preserve is prepared by impregnating with high amount of sugar in them. So once that is being done, so the next step, the candy is prepared by drying the preserve. So you dry the preserve, it becomes a candy. So once the candy is dried, and then if it is covered with a thin transparent coat of sugar, so if it is covered with a thin transparent of coat of sugar, which gives a glaze means a shine, so that becomes a glazed fruit. If the same candied fruit, if it is coated with the sugar crystals, so by rolling it in a sugar powder, so then it becomes a crystallized fruit. So are you getting my point? So here basically all these products which are on the slide, all these are basically prepared from the preserve. So preserve is the ultimate source from which all these products are prepared. So a tenderized fruit, so which is cooked transparent and tender, is used for the preparation of candy, and from candy your glazed fruit and crystallized fruit are going to be prepared. The famous examples of this candy are petha, and you have different types of other preserves like murabba and carrot preserves, ginger candy. So these are all popular in the Indian tradition, where they are liked for their flavor and taste. Here I would like to introduce some of the popular preserves that are being prepared from fruits like amla, amla murabba, apple preserve, karanda preserve, bale preserve, strawberry preserve, and papaya preserve. So there are lot many fruits from which the preserves can be prepared. So, but here I have shown some of the fruits from which the preserves can be prepared. As you can see, all these preserves look moist. So they're all moist and they are highly impregnated with high amount of sugar in them. And these fruits are cooked to a consistency where they become tender and transparent. So the fruits which are used for this preparation of preserve are from a matured fruit, and then they'll be cooked to an extent where they become transparent, tender, and they get impregnated with high amount of sugar in them. Let's see how a preserve is being prepared. So in this slide you can see a flowchart for the preparation of a preserve. Let's imagine that we are going to prepare a preserve from amla. So that is amla ka murabba. So we'll try to prepare amla murabba or amla preserve, so which is most popular and has got many health benefits, and even it is popular in India. So here a fruit, how it is selected. So generally, if a fruit has to be selected for preparation of preserve, it has to be selected, neither it has to be overripe nor underripe. It has to be just underripe. So slightly underripe fruits are selected. And then how do you prepare the fruit? So you prepare the fruit by peeling it in certain cases and by not peeling it in certain cases, and then by removing the nut seeds inside. And then next step is by picking or puncturing. You make picks to permeate the entry of sugar syrup in it, and then soaking the fruit to allow it to absorb the sugar syrup, and then blanching it. So you're blanching it in boiling water so that the fruit becomes, the harder fruit becomes softened, and then you prepare a sugar syrup. So you have prepared the fruit, you have softened it, and then you have made it some punctures or pricks or holes on it to allow the sugar syrup to enter into the fruit, and then that is includes your fruit preparation. Once your fruit is prepared by soaking and blanching, the next step is you need to prepare a sugar syrup. So by required amount of water and required amount of sugar, by adding it either equal to the amount of fruits that you are going to take or twice the amount of fruits that you are going to take. Again, it depends upon the type of fruit that you are using. So once you prepare a syrup, and then you need to cook in syrup. So that means you are going to put the fruits in the sugar syrup and cook the process, that is you will be cooking the fruits, the mixture of fruits as well as the syrup, so that desired bricks is attained. So once this desired bricks is attained by using different methods of cooking, methods like your rapid process, slow process, or vacuum process. So once it is done, so then finally you will end up the product to be cooled and then packed. Let's see step by step process of preparation of preserve. The first step is fruit selection. So in the while selecting a fruit, you need to select a fruit which is slightly underripe. So the fruit has to be completely developed, but it shouldn't be very underripe or unripe or overripe. So if it is underripe, it is not fit, or overripe, it is not fit. It has to be a stage at which it is slightly underripe. So such fruits are suitable for preparation of a preserve. And the next step involves preparation of the fruit. So fruits which are selected, they need to be thoroughly washed and remove the portions which are damaged or diseased or bruised. So in this preparation of fruit, either you may use whole fruit or pieces or slices of the fruit. It depends upon the type of the fruit that you are using. And again, while preparing, some of the fruits has to be peeled. Some of the fruits need not be peeled. It depends upon the skin texture, skin nature. If the skin nature is thin, then you need not peel it. If the skin nature is thick, so just like in the case of your mango, apple or bale, so wherein which it has got thick skin, so in such cases you need to remove the skin as well as core or seeds or stones. So they have to be removed so that it will help in the permeation, in the absorption of the sugars syrup, so that the sugar concentration gets impregnated. So I think you got the point. So that means the fruits which are thin skinned like berries need not be peeled, and the thick skin fruits need to be peeled. After selecting and preparation of the fruit, peeling and removing of the seeds and core, the next step is preparing the fruit for absorption of the sugar syrup. So the sugar syrup has to enter inside the prepared fruit. How it can be done? By making prickings or by puncturing the fruit. So here we use a fork kind of thing, or stainless steel forks or wooden prickers, so that it forms holes on the surface of the prepared fruit, so that the sugar syrup starts entering into the fruit and then gets impregnated. So to do that, what we need to do, we need to take the fruits and puncture it with stainless steel or wooden prickers so that the sugars gets into the fruits, and make sure you don't puncture it too much, or else the fruit becomes too soft and it won't hold to its texture. Then it loses its shape and it becomes no more a preserve. It becomes more like a jam. So because the fruit pieces or the entire fruit will lose its shape as a result of excessive pricking. To help these fruits to permeate the syrup efficiently, so these fruits are soaked either in brine or alum or water for a few hours to few days before blanching. So they are allowed to soak in brine or alum so these fruits will become highly porous. So this will help in even checking browning. So the browning will be stopped as a result of soaking in salt water, and even it has the tendency to remove astringency if there is a high concentration of tannins. So that can be removed as a result of soaking, and even it will minimize shrinkage. So if you prepare the fruit initially so that it can absorb more amount of sugar syrup, when the fruits are kept in high concentrated sugar syrups, the shrinkage will not be observed. So if you place the fruits in very high concentration, so without preparing them, without making them tender, without making them ready for absorption of high sugar concentration, they will be shrinking. So that can be minimized by soaking, and even the stiffening or hardening of the fruits will be prevented by soaking. So the soaking has got various advantages. It makes the fruit highly porous, so that when a fruit is placed in high concentrated sugar syrup and cooked for a longer period of time, the shrinkage will be prevented, and then hardening or stiffening of the fruit will be prevented, and the discoloration is prevented, and even the astringency will be removed due to this soaking process. We have made impervious fruit, non-porous fruit, pervious, or it has become porous. So by pricking them and even by soaking them in brine or in alum. So we will prepare the fruit so that the texture of the fruit will become softer. The hard texture of the fruit will become softer by blanching them in boiling water. So you place the fruits in muslin cloth and then put it in the boiling water for a few minutes, maybe 5 to 10 minutes. Again, it depends upon the texture of the fruit. If it is a hard textured fruit, you need to place it for a longer period of time compared to the softer texture fruits. And then when you're blanching, excessive blanching has to be avoided, so as it causes excessive softening, and then fruit tissues will not be able to hold, and then eventually your preserve won't be coming in a proper shape. And the complete preparation of the fruit is ready. Now we have selected the fruit, prepared the fruit, and then you have pricked it and then soaked it so that it will become porous. It will permeate the sugar concentration into the fruit, and then you have blanched it, made it softer. So here comes the end of the preparation of the fruit, and then now the fruits are ready to be placed in the sugar syrup. So how do you prepare this sugar syrup? So for preparation of the sugar syrup, how much amount of sugar has to be used and how much amount of water? So for sugar, so it depends upon the type of fruit that you are using. So either it may be equal amount of sugar, the amount of fruits that you are taking, or twice the amount of fruits so that you have taken. So you, depending upon the fruit type, you will use either equal quantity of sugar or the twice the quantity of the fruits. And then this sugar has to be boiled with 2 to 3 times that of the what? That 2 to 3 times that of the sugar. And then along with addition of citric acid or tartaric acid at a concentration of 0.3 to 0.4%. So this acid will help in removing the dirt. So while cooking, so there will be froth that emerges, so that has to be removed. So this is how you need to prepare the sugar syrup. So just by taking the required amount of sugar, adding 2 to 3 times the water, and then along with that you add a citric acid, and then prepare a syrup by boiling it. Now the prepared fruits and the sugar syrup mixed and then boiled together or cooked together. So for cooking of this mixture of fruit and the syrup, there are 3 types of cooking, so which include a rapid process, a slow process, and a vacuum method. So these will vary on the rate at which and the quality of the preserve that is being prepared. Here the end point is judged by the attainment of degree of bricks. If you see that the degree of bricks in the syrup has reached 68 and above 70 degree bricks, so that means a preserve is done. So this can be done by these 3 methods: the rapid cooking or slow cooking or vacuum method. In this rapid process or open kettle process, so which is a rapid method, which is a fast method or a quick method. So in this quick method, so what is usually done, the fruits are cooked in very low sugar concentration, and slowly the initial low sugar concentration is raised by cooking in a open kettle or open pan. So the fruits along with the sugar syrup, which is initially at low concentration, the concentration is raised slowly by increasing the degree bricks by continuous heating, a gentle heating, so until the syrup becomes sufficiently thick. So when you start heating, the concentration of the sugar increases. You cook till the sugar concentration has reached 68 degree bricks, so or even which corresponds to, so when you are the boiling point of the sugar syrup reaches 106 degrees Celsius. So this degree bricks, that is 68 or above degree bricks, has to be reached not rapidly. It has to be reached in such a way that it has to be very gentle, and then it needs to take its own sweet time. If you do it very rapidly, the fruits will become toughened and it won't be softer as a preserve has to be. In the previous rapid method of cooking, the cooking process is completed within a day. So wherein the fruit pieces or the entire whole fruits are cooked in the low sugar syrup, and then gradually the sugar syrup concentration has brought to 68 degree Brix. So this process is carried out under continuous heat, so wherein there are chances of loss of flavor and loss of nutrients due to continuous heating. Unlike this rapid process, this slow process is rather slow, and it takes around 7 days for the complete formation of a preserve, so which is cooked delicately, and then it helps in the preservation or helps retention of the flavor, and it gives a better quality than the rapid method of cooking. And this method takes a very long time than the rapid method of cooking. In this slow method of process, the fruits or the pieces or the slices of fruit are cut, and then they are arranged alternate layers with the sugar. So one layer of fruits followed by one layer of sugar, so it is continued like that. So the amount of sugar that has to be used is equal to the half the weight of the fruits. If you take 1 kg of fruits, half kg of sugar has to be used. So these pieces of fruits are placed alternating layers of fruit and sugar, and then they are allowed to stay for a 24 hours. So during this process, what will happen? The water that is present inside the fruit slowly leaches out and then mixes with the sugar and forms a solution. So the water will move from the fruits into the sugar, and then the sugar gets turned into a syrup, so which is having a degree Brix of 37 to 38 degree Brix. So on the first day, so there is no cooking, and then on the second day, so once it is allowed to stand for 24 hours, so during which the water from the fruits is seeped or leached into the sugar, and then it turns out to be syrup. And then on the second day, what you'll do? So you'll add sugar and then citric acid, so that it will cause inversion. So it will be production of reducing sugars, so which is further boiled for 3 to 4 minutes. So this boiling makes the sugar to raise its degree Brix to 60 degree. So the sugar concentration is increased as a result of addition of sugar, citric acid, and then further boiling on the day 2. On the third day, the sugar concentration is increased by adding sugar and boiling it for 3 to 4 minutes, and the degree Brix reaches to 68 degree Brix, and this is allowed to stay for 3 to 4 days. And finally, on the 7th day, the strength of the syrup is raised to 70 degree Brix. So after 3 to 4 days, the degree Brix has to be raised by further cooking at the end, so that final strength of the syrup has to be 70 degree Brix. The third method of cooking of preserve is by using vacuum cooking. In this method of cooking, the fruits are initially softened, so they are softened by normal cooking, and once the syrup's concentration, syrup strength reaches 30 to 35 degree Brix, then the contents are transferred to a vacuum pan. So wherein which the vacuum pan uses the basic principle involved, wherein which the evaporation is carried out at a very low temperature. So there's the P is directly proportional to temperature. The temperature is reduced, temperature of evaporation is reduced as the pressure is reduced. So in a vacuum pan, the pressure is less. So as the temperature of evaporation is also less. So under low temperatures, there is an evaporation of moisture from the sugar syrup. So when the moisture evaporates at very low temperature, so then your concentration, that is your sugar syrup concentration, is reduced to 70 degree bricks at very low temperatures. For such type of cooking, and in such type of cookings, whatever the produce that is being produced will be of better quality in terms of retention of flavor as well as the color. While cooking the syrup in open pan, you need to take certain precautions, like the kind of pan you use for cooking and the strength of the syrup that you use initially. It all affect the quality of the preserve that will be prepared at the end of the process. So whenever you use a pan, it has to be a deep pan. So deep pan, usually it increases the strength of the syrup gradually. If you use a shallow pan, the strength of the sugar will be increased suddenly or rapidly. So to avoid that one, we need to use a pan which is deeper. So a deeper pan is always better than the one which is shallower. The shallower ones get the syrup consistency increased rapidly, thereby there will be a lot of effects wherein which the fruit may become shriveled or even it may become toughened as a result of a sudden increase in the strength of the sugar syrup. And even the syrup penetration is also affected by the strength of the syrup. If it is a thin syrup, then gradually it penetrates the fruit and then gets impregnated. So there won't be any problem if it has started off your cooking process using a thin syrup, and it has to be increased gradually. And even if you directly put the fruits in a highly concentrated syrup, it causes either toughened fruits or shriveled preserves. So you will be losing the shape or even the tenderness of the these preserves that are prepared when you directly put these fruits into the highly concentrated syrup. And finally, once you prepare the syrup, it has to be completely covered with the sugar syrup, so to make sure that they won't be dried. Once they are dried, they will lose the quality. So it's always better to keep the fruits which are formed as a result of cooking process. As after preparation of the preserve, they always need to be covered with the sugar syrup. After preparation of the preserve is allowed to cool quickly. So once it is cooled quickly, it will prevent any kind of browning or discoloration. So then it can be stored. If it is required to store them in 8 1/2 size cans, it is done just exactly the way it is carried out in the case of your canning. Only thing is, whatever the syrup that has been used for cooking of this preserve is removed, and then these only the fruits are the slices of fruits, so which are made as a preserve, are taken. They are filled into this 8 1/2 size cans, and then a fresh syrup, so not the syrup which has been used for the preparation of the preserve, a fresh hot boiling syrup which is having a strength of 68 degree bricks is used for filling these cans. So once you fill the cans, the way that you carry out in the case of canning, exhausting, and then sterilization is carried out. Exhaustion is carried out at 100 degree Celsius in the steam for 8 to 10 minutes. So after exhaustion, after removing of any kind of entrapped air, then it is allowed to sterilize at 100 degrees Celsius for 20 to 25 minutes, and then finally it is allowed to cool and store. Next product of our discussion is a candied fruit. This candied fruit is similar to that of a preserve. So once you prepare the preserve, so that means a fruit or vegetable which is impregnated with cane sugar or glucose syrup. So once it is impregnated with high amount of sugar in them, and then what you do is you drain off the syrup and then dry them. See here in the preserve, you don't dry the preserve. It is always covered under the syrup, unlike the candied fruit. The candied fruits are prepared from the preserve. So it is just like the way the preserve is prepared, and then only thing is you remove the syrup and dry it and then store it. So that becomes a candied fruit. So that means candy is nothing but a preserve which is dried from the syrup. To prevent the fermentation of these candies, the sugar concentration is kept about 75% so that they can stay for a longer periods of time. And the candies are made from very popular fruits or vegetables, like your ginger candy, which is made from ginger, and the peels, so which are having a rich flavor, like oranges. So orange peel can be used in preparation of candies for their rich flavor, and even the citron can be used. The citron peels are also used. Even the waste material, like used in the case of your pineapple canning. So the out of pineapple canning, you will get waste material, a lot of waste material of core, and this core is used in the preparation of candies. So the candies can be prepared from the fruits or vegetables which are having a rich flavor or a very good flavor, so which gives a nice candy. Here you can see different kinds of candies from different fruits and vegetables, from amla, that's amla candy, pineapple candy, karanda candy, kiwi candy, or ginger candy, or papaya candy. So this, as you can see, these candies are devoid of any kind of syrup on surface of them. So they are completely dried, so they do not have any kind of syrup adhered to them. So they will completely remove the syrup which is adhering to them, and then they will be dried completely to make it as a candy. So it's a slightly different from the preserve. The preserve is moist in and their appearance, and the candies are dry in their appearance. Here you can see the citron fruit from which candy is prepared, which gives a very flavorful candy. And also the orange peels are also used for preparation of candy. So citron peel and orange peels are also used for the preparation of candies. Preparation of candy is similar to that of what you have seen in the case of preserve. So just like the way the preserve is prepared, the candy is also prepared. Only the third step, as you can see from the slide, is slightly different from that of the preserve. The first step, as usual, you prepare the fruit, and then in the second step you cook it in the syrup. So just like the way you carry out in the case of cooking of preserve. So once you prepare the preserve, and if you remove the adhering sugar syrup or the covering sugar syrup, and then it is washed thoroughly so that the surface adhered syrup is removed, and then it is completely dried, so that becomes a candy. So a preserve is dried, that becomes a candy. The first step of preparation of candy is the preparation of the fruit, wherein which the fruit is thoroughly washed to remove any kind of salts in them. So you leach out the salts present in the fruit or fruit peels, and then they are allowed to be blanched. They are allowed to blanch in hot boiling water, so that the texture of the fruit will be softened. The hardness of the fruit is gone, and you will get a soft texture, so which will allow the absorption or the penetration of the sugar or the glucose into the fruit. After the fruit is leached out of its salts and softened by blanching, now the fruits are ready for cooking in the syrup. On the first day, these fruits or fruit pieces or the peels are boiled in a low concentration of sugar syrup, that is 30 degree breaks, along with citric acid of 0.1%, and they are boiled for a period of 10 to 15 minutes on the first day. And then on the second day, the syrup concentration has to be increased by further adding of sugar and then further boiling for 5 minutes. So then the strength of the sugar syrup will be increased to 40 degree breaks. So from first day to second day, there is an increase of 10 degree breaks. And this process has to be repeated continuously. So this has to be repeated continuously so that this strength of the syrup reaches a strength of around 60 degree breaks. Once this strength has been increased to 60 degree breaks, and slowly and progressively the degree breaks or the strength of the sugar syrup has to be increased 5 degree breaks on every alternate day by boiling the mass. So you boil it one day and leave it like that the other day, and then again boil on the other day, on the third day. So by alternate days boiling, by boiling the sugar syrup and then slowly raising the strength of the bricks by 5 degrees, you will be reaching final strength of the sugar 70 degree bricks. So that is the 75 degree bricks, that is the final strength of the sugar strength required in a case of a sugar syrup. That means the strength of the sugar syrup from 30 degree bricks is increased gradually and progressively at the rate of 5 degree bricks, and it has to reach a final strength of 75 degree bricks to make into a fine candy. The final step of candy making is draining the syrup, which is used for cooking and impregnation of the sugar, into the fruits or the fruit peels. So it is drained for a period of about half an hour so that the complete sugar syrup is completely removed or drained out. So once it is drained out, and then you will be left with only the pieces or the fruit pieces or the fruit peels or the fruits, and then you try to sort out the defective ones or the ones which are not properly tenderized, and then they are not of good quality. So the sorting is carried out. So once the sorting is done, and still there will be certain amount of syrup that is adhering on the surface of these fruit pieces. This adhering sugar syrup has to be removed just by putting these fruit pieces or the fruits or the fruit peels into hot boiling water just for a few minutes, and then take it out so that the surface sugar syrup has been removed. And then these dipped fruits in hot water are allowed to dry, either by sheer drying or by quick drying in a oven, or by placing them in trays in a hot air oven at a temperature of 66 degrees Celsius for a period of 8 to 10 hours. Either slow drying or hot air oven drying can be practiced for complete drying of these fruit pieces or the fruit peels. Glazed fruit is prepared from the candies. The candies which are dried or coated with a thin transparent coat of sugar. So this thin transparent coat of sugar covering is called as glazing. The process which involves a covering of thin transparent coat of sugar on the surface of the candies is called as glazing, and such fruits are called as glazed fruits. For preparation of a glazed fruit, you just need to know about glazing or making a glossy appearance to the candy. So you already know about the candy preparation. Use the same candies over which you try to give a transparent covering of sugar coat. So how to prepare this glaze or glossy appearance or a thin transparent coat of glaze? So this glaze is prepared by mixing sugar and water in a ratio of 2:1, and this mixture, this sugar syrup, is allowed to boil in a steam pan at a temperature of 113 to 114 degrees Celsius. So once it has been boiled, and then it is to be cooled down to 93 degree Celsius. So after cooling it down, then you try to rub a wooden ladle along the edges on the sides of the pan. You rub using a wooden ladle along the sides of the pan so that granulation, sugar granulation occurs. This sugar granulation is achieved by rubbing a wooden ladle along the pan or along the sides of the pan. So this sugar granules are used for coating on the dried candies. So use the sugar granules. So you allow these candies to pass through the sugar granules which you have prepared, and so these sugar granules will form a thin coating on the surface of the candies. The candies which are covered with the granulated portion of the sugar, and they are allowed to dry. So by placing them on trays for drying, for further drying in a dryer at a temperature of 49 degrees for 2 to 3 hours, and they become crispy. Such crispy fruit pieces or fruit peels are further packed and stored in airtight containers. Crystallized fruit is slightly different from that of the glazed fruit. In the case of a glazed fruit, the candy is coated with thin transparent coating of sugar. So this coating is transparent coating, which is done with the help of a sugar. But in the case of a crystallized fruit, crystals of sugar are coated onto the candy. Is it clear? In the case of a glazed fruit, if a candy is coated with a thin transparent covering of a sugar syrup which is transparent, so that becomes a glazed fruit or a glossy. It gives a glossy appearance. In the case of a crystallized fruit, this is coated with sugar crystals. Either the sugar crystals are formed by rolling the candies in the crystals of sugar, or by pouring high concentrated sugar syrup on these candies and allowing them to deposit sugar crystals on these candies. So that's how a crystallized fruit is formed. How sugar crystals are coated onto the surface of candies. So this can be done either by rolling the candies on the powdered sugar, or by allowing the deposition of sugar syrup, and then eventually they will form sugar crystals on the surface of the candies. So in this process, the candy fruits are arranged on the wire mesh tray. So they are placed on a wire mesh tray in a deep vessel. So once they are placed, then on top of this candies are going to pour high concentrated sugar syrup which is cooled. Cooled sugar syrup which is of strength of 70% TSS. So this sugar syrup is allowed to pour on the surface of these candies gently, so that this sugar syrup is evenly distributed on the surface of these candies. And then this entire mass, the sugar syrup coated onto the surface of the candies and the fruits and the wire mesh tray, is allowed to stand still without being disturbed for a period of 12 to 18 hours. So during this process, what will happen? There is a formation of crystallized sugar on the surface of the candies. And then after a period of 18 hours, the tray is taken out carefully, and then the excess sugar syrup is drained off. You remove the excess sugar syrup, and then these fruits, so which are the candies, so which are coated with the sugar syrup, so which eventually led to the formation of sugar crystals, are allowed to dry by placing them in a single layer mesh. So they are placed for drying in a room or a room temperature, or under a shade, or even at 49 degrees Celsius in the dryers, to allow them to become crispy,
so that eventually you will be getting a crystallized fruit. So a crystallized fruit is formed from a candy by pouring them with sugar syrup and allowing them to form sugar crystals and then drying them. For packing of this crystallized glazed or candies, so usual method of practicing in the retail market is for preserves, they are stored in tin containers or even glass jars are popular for the storage of preserves. So if for candies and the crystallized fruits or even the peels, so they are stored either singly, so that means the entire candies or crystallized fruits, they are stored in containers, so completely like that, or else in the form of layers, so one layer of candies and followed by a layer of waterproof paper or like a polythene paper, and then another layer of your candies. So alternate layers of candies and then waterproof paper or polythene is used. For the sake of export market attractive China or porcelain jars, so which are externally attractive jars or metal or glass containers or even the cheaper flexible films are used for the export market of this crystallized or glazed fruits. There are few defects and spoilages that you encounter during the preparation of a candy, a preserve, crystallized or a glazed fruit. So some of them are includes your fermentation or mold growth. So fermentation is due to the use of very low concentration of sugar syrup in the initial stages of boiling the syrup for boiling preserve. So if this occurs, it causes fermentation due to low concentration of sugar syrup. So this can be avoided or can be prevented or can be corrected by boiling the product at proper intervals, so it will develop into a good product without undergoing any kind of fermentation. Another defect is the mold growth. So this occurs when you store the product, so when you store the prepared product at a condition which is humid. Under humid conditions, if you store these products, it causes mold growth. So this can be prevented by storing them in airtight dry containers, which will eventually prevent the growth of mold growth. Other defects and spoilages that occur in the preparation of these products is, the first one is the shrunken preserve. When a preserve becomes shrunk, so when you initially cook the preserve in a sugar syrup, the concentration has to be initially low and gradually it has to be increased. If you directly use a high concentrated or a heavy syrup, then the fruits or the preserve will become shrunk and then it will lose its shape. So that's why you need to use a low degree breaks sugar syrup for preservation, preparation of the sugar syrup for boiling. Sometimes the preserves may be dull or brown or discolored. This is due to the raw material which are faulty, inferior quality raw material. It may be underripe raw material or even it may be overcooking. So when you cook after adding sugar into the syrup, then you overcook it more than the requirement, then it causes caramelization or it may cause browning. In such cases, the quality of the produce is lost, or even it may be due to the formation of dust and debris over boiling. So when you are boiling the syrup, there may be dust and debris which is present in the sugar gets accumulated on the surface as scum. So if you don't remove that scum, it will lead to the dull and faded or cloudy preserve, so which is not a good character of the preserve. So it can be corrected by using good quality fruit. Just underripe fruit can be used for selection of the fruit and correct cooking to get a desired degree breaks. And if you don't cook the peels properly till they become tender and soft enough to prepare a preserve, then the fruit peels or the fruit pieces will become very tough once they are cooked along with the sugar syrup. So for that, you need to cook these peels or the fruit pieces until they become tender. Then only they are boiled or cooked in a sugar syrup. Not only does a preserve is going to become cloudy or foggy or dull and faded because of use of poor quality or inferior quality produce, it also develops molds on the surface of the preserve as a result of use of inferior quality produce, but also due to undercooking and warm storage of this preserve under warm or high humid conditions or damp conditions. So under such conditions, there is a development of molds. So molds usually thrive well under situation where there is a warmth, where there is a high humidity. In such conditions, where the fruit or the preserve is not properly cooked or undercooked, under such conditions, the molds grow well. So for which you need to cook well and store them in a cool, dry place, wherein which you can avoid the growth of mold. By using good quality fruits. If you use a low concentration of sugar or the cooking is not proper, is insufficient, when you store the produce in warm places, you get to see a fermented preserve after storage. So this can be avoided by storing them in a cool, dry place. If the sugar strength is not reached to the requirement of a candy, so that means for preparation of candy it requires around 75 degree bricks in the final concentration. If it has not reached the final concentration of 75 degree bricks, then you will see candies which are sticky in nature even after they have been dried. So that is due to the poor concentration of the sugar syrup. So you need to prepare a proper sugar syrup, so which has to reach 75 degree bricks before you completely dry the candies from the syrup. If the candies or crystallized or glazed fruits are not properly stored in containers which are airtight, so if there is slight entry of air or moisture into the containers, so these are products which are dry in nature, so which spontaneously absorb moisture present in the air, then they start becoming sticky. So even though they are dried, because of the exposure or poor packaging or by storing them in a condition which is moist or damp conditions, so that's why you need to always store them in correct storage conditions. So by storing them in airtight containers and prepare a sugar syrup of correct concentration.